mind meld between Sarah Chalke and Jessica. We'll get to that too. Chris Parnell is here, but not carrying a baby, but rather.
No, it's a sling. It's called an ultra sling.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is,
sling
it, is it ultra?
It is. See, there's the name.
Oh, there.
This is also a.
This is why it's great to work in animation, because you can have slings and yet still do the gig.
That's right.
We're going to talk about Rick and Morty in a second, but I was saying you've never looked better in your whole life. But you were saying that the number one.
Sarah, it's true.
That the number, well, here, number one, it's being Canadian. That's always the key.
As the air?
Yeah. You can't succeed in television unless you're Canadian. And you said you feel like as if you're 28. And yeah. Jessica says that all the time.
28's the age.
Yeah.
And now that we're 29, it's weird that we.
I know. Yeah.
28.
So I'm with you, Sarah. Yeah.
But I paused there.
Right. Okay. Yeah. Fair enough. Rick and Morty, season 3. And what makes. I assume. I don't, are you guys laughing as you do it?
Not usually, no. I'm just in character. I'm a serious actor.
He's very serious. I'm laughing all the time. I'm not a serious actor.
I laugh sometimes at the direction that I'm given from Justin or Dan.
And the direction is like, be more somber or make it nuttier or what?
All kinds of stuff, all kinds of stuff.
Are you in the studio together or do you guys just do
it's
it?
All separate.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it the first time you met Sarah? Do you want to learn more about her?
I really do. I've been fascinated by her for years and loved her on Scrubs and it's so nice to finally meet you.
We sort of work in a bit of a vacuum. You're recording all the episodes separately, and then so it's exciting because obviously for two reasons. I mean, when you read the scripts for Rick and Morty, you can't picture like what the intergalactic, you know, Federation, what this alien's going to look like, this two-headed testicle monster. It's hard to imagine what the animators can come up with.
Right.
And then also you haven't ever read with the other actors, so it's always
a treat.
A surprise, yeah.
It's a treat to finally see it, which is always like a year later and you've
forgotten. Well, they were saying this time a year and a half. Was there a delay in the a long coffee break or?
It was the writing, you know. They just had a hard time getting the scripts to where they wanted them, you know, and because the writing is just so sharp and detailed and specific, and they have a really high standard, and it took a while to get there.
All right. Well, we have a clip. Take a look at the Adult Swim now classic Rick and Morty watch.
You're not sure what you do for a living, you can make your own rules.
Summer, show your father some respect. He's pulling down a 6 chewable figure income.
I'll get that in a moment. How are everyone's pills? Oh, Morty, you've hardly touched your pills.
I kind of had big pills for lunch, and I wasn't going to eat any more pills. Thank you, Conroy.
You spoil us, Conroy.
Grandpa Rick wouldn't put up with this. Stop saying his name. He abandoned us.
Willem Dafoe. That's the guy I couldn't think of this morning.
That is really funny stuff. Look at that. Did you know that Chris was named the most talented person in his high school?
I did not know that. I am not surprised.
Yes.
Most talented male.
Okay.
Senior year, there was a most talented woman.
What's happened to her?
No, I haven't kept up with
her. All
right. No, Chris.
How do you know this about Chris?
I've researched him. No, but you're in everything, and you're doing a lot of animation work now.
Yeah, thank God for animation. Yeah, it's been great. And then I'm excited. I'm doing a spinoff of the show Blackish called College-ish that we're going to start shooting at the end of August, I think. Yeah, so that's exciting. I still get to be on TV every now and then.
Well, but more than now and then.
Yeah. Well.
I think I was voted least likely.
But was it in some school in Ottawa?
It was in Vancouver, the other side of Canada. And I, it wasn't, high school was not my time. I grew much later in life. Mm. I could not make any sports teams, so I had to be in race walking.
Like the most Canadian thing to me ever.
I was
race walking.
Well, because I wanted to go to the meets and get on the bus. Aww. I was like, I'll do anything. And what is nobody signing up for?
Like
what
could they possibly get in?
So you just had to walk really fast.
Race walking. Yeah. It's more than that. It's actually very cardiovascular. No, it's you walk really fast. There's only one rule. It's that you can't have both feet on the ground at the same time. One foot on the ground at all times, otherwise it's running. That's the only thing that
did you have cool uniforms at least? Or?
No, there was nothing cool about it. They throw the girls and the guys on the track at the same time, even though you're not competing against each other, just to like get
it. Now, if Chris had done race walking, would he have injured his rotary cuff?
My rotary cuffs are fine.
See, we could have saved you. We could have helped you out there.
Now, isn't it how ironic though? You're from Vancouver, and now you're here. Yet the whole business is in Vancouver.
You're
on the bus the wrong direction.
Totally. I mean, when I started out, there was a lot of filming up there, but it was sort of like, I mean, my entire beginning of my resume is like this string of like, you know, Our Mother's Murder, Dying to Belong, Relentless, The Mind of a Killer, Moment of Truth, Stand Against Fear, like just really
the classics.
That's really good. Speaking of classics, how about Roseanne coming back?
I'm so excited.
Oh.
I'm so excited. Yeah, I can't wait.
Okay, fair enough.
I'm not allowed to say anything, or they're going to replace my character with someone else.
We don't want to get into trouble.
No chance.
Here is everything we need to know. New episodes of the third season of Rick and Morty, Sundays at 11:30 on Adult Swim. Chris and Sarah, nice to see you both.
Thanks for having us.
Still ahead, powerful images caught on camera.
The new video just in showing a man and a dog surviving an extremely dangerous situation when a flash flood suddenly hit.
Then flight attendants have to deal with many different types of requests, but now we're learning the one question that crew members say makes their blood boil, the drink they want you to stop ordering.
And we're giving away tickets to see Mamma Mia. You can win coming up in the Anchor Challenge.